I'd like to welcome now Sylvia Boudreau, who is the co-organizer with the exciting Winnipeg Indigenous Rock the Vote campaign. They rocked the vote in the municipal elections. They raised awareness about Indigenous rights to vote and were successful in getting Indigenous people out to vote, young and old. They had many first-time voters and many Indigenous candidates, from mayor to city councillors and school trustees. Now they are working hard on the next campaign to get more Indigenous people out voting in the next federal election. Welcome, Sylvia.
Hi there. Thank you very much for that greeting. It actually really caught me off guard, so I'm quite honored for that. I do definitely as well want to acknowledge the fact that we are on Treaty 1 territory, and I do want to give thanks to the Council of Canadians and the Canadian Union of Public Employees for the invite to come and speak this evening. Well, I thought one of the things that I wanted to just begin by saying, because I think it's really important when we look at and think about Aboriginal people in voting, and we have to, for those that aren't aware or may not be aware, that at one point in time, Aboriginal people were not allowed to vote. Aboriginal people of Canada were only given the right to vote in 1960. So when you kind of think of in terms of generation of trying to motivate people and getting individuals out to use and exercise their rights to vote, it becomes much more of a challenge. Actually I'll just give a little bit of background on Winnipeg Indigenous Rock the Vote. It was actually a brainstorm that came from Jackie Travers, who's a local Winnipeg artist, who's sitting right there. She can be a little camera shy, but I still like to make sure that honoring is given to where the idea and where the notion came from. So thank you for that, Jackie. Basically, Jackie really strongly wanted to create change, and she just got tired of the ongoing comments and racism around Aboriginal people. So part of that, out of that grew the impetus to start looking at what can we do to create change and to encourage Aboriginal people to get out and vote. Many times when we've been out in some of the community events, individuals will say, well, it doesn't matter, my vote doesn't count. And I have to say that I was one of those individuals years ago. I wouldn't vote for the simple fact that I didn't see that there was any value in it. And it's something that along the way I've certainly learned to embrace, and now being able to put out that awareness and encourage other Aboriginal people that there is reason to vote and there is value in our voting. Some of the things that we had aimed to do with Winnipeg Indigenous Rock of the Vote, it really was a grassroots campaign to, again, bring awareness to the Aboriginal people. At the time, we started with the civic elections here in Winnipeg, and as Brigette had mentioned, we had a couple of mayoral candidates that were Aboriginal. We had school trustees. This past civic election was the most numbers that we had for Aboriginal candidates, and I think that really spoke out and gave us the drive to continue and keep going further with this. What we did do is we had made and created, and I encourage you to check out on YouTube. There was a number of YouTube videos with Winnipeg Indigenous Rock the Vote. We held a community forum with most of all of the candidates for mayor. And that was actually well received, and being able to bring something into the community so that people can see and just begin to try and experience some of the processes that do happen with voting. We had a number of public announcements. We had newspaper articles. We did radio interviews. With the Facebook page, the very first Facebook page, we had over 2,727 members. With the current Winnipeg Indigenous Rock, in the 42nd federal election, we currently have 1,502 members. And the third page that is basically for all across Canada to again share the information and encourage individuals to be informed has 633 members. My thinking is it's still early. People aren't necessarily in that mode of thinking of voting and the election, so we're going to hang in there for a while. Oh, sorry. Just to give you an idea of some of the current federal election 2015 Indigenous voting face groups pages that we know of. Of course, there's ours, which is the Winnipeg Indigenous Rock the Vote in the 42nd election, October 19, 2015. The X Initiative, Rally the First Nation Vote, which is out of Sault Ste. Marie. Voice to Vote, hashtag PA, hashtag 2015. First Nations Rock the Vote, Kenora. Canada's Indigenous Rock the Federal Election, 2015. And Brandon Aboriginal Voters 2015 towards national elections. Some of the pages are Indigenous Vote Saskatchewan 2015, Indigenous Vote Alberta 2015, Indigenous Vote Lethbridge, Indigenous Politics, and Vancouver Indigenous Rock the Vote. So it's really It's empowering, and it's a wonderful thing to see that people are starting to pay attention and starting to get involved and just grasp into the idea about politics. We've seen what has been done under the Conservative government, not only with the Aboriginal people, but with the veterans, with the water, with the fracking. There's a number of things that have really just put things in a more challenging position. And the one thing I'm just going to leave individuals with, right now in my hand I'm holding what we call as a grandfather. And when I need strength or I need to speak words, that can be a challenge for me. I always keep a grandfather with me to remind me and to ground me. But for every one of us, including this water, if we don't protect this water, if we don't protect the grandfathers, if we don't take care of Mother Earth, she's not going to be there for future generations. Miigwech.